Many of the problems our support team sees are due to the JTAG interface circuit not having been optimally designed. So in this series of videos, we're going to share our hints, tips, and best practices on getting that right. Even if you're an experienced JTAG user, there'll probably be topics here to help you. We'll cover things like getting the necessary high-speed terminations in place, a method for checking you've got the best signal integrity, how to set up a reliable reset sequence, and such like. By following these guides, you should be able to implement a JTAG chain that's robust and that serves you well. In this first video, we'll deal with the physical interface, then we'll follow with advanced topics as the series continues. But don't skip this first video because there will be things to check if you want your test system to run smoothly. By physical interface, we mean the cable and its connectors. This is an XJ-Link 2. JTAG often runs at tens of megahertz, so we've got to be careful about things like grounding, or we're going to have problems with intermittent faults. You've probably seen boards that have more than one JTAG port, and an important thing to note is that each of those ports must have at least one solid ground connection running up the cable. If you're using an XJ-Link 2, you can support up to four ports simultaneously, but be aware that its connector only has two solid grounds. If you need to connect to three or four ports, we recommend that you use a splitter board that distributes those grounds so that each connector has enough. It's really important to ensure that the ground on each of the board's JTAG connectors runs down the cable alongside its own signals to the ground connection on the XJ-Link 2. If that doesn't happen, you're likely to end up with communication failures. Now let's look at the pinout itself. We're going to have to be careful about crosstalk, so, most importantly, where do those signals run in the cable? All four main JTAG signals run at speed and have sharp edges that can generate interference. But you need to pay extra attention to TDO because, unlike the others, you don't control its slew rate. So the first thing to do is to keep TDO physically separated from T-clock, because you don't want crosstalk causing spurious clock edges. If you're using a ribbon cable, you'll also need at least one ground between them. As far as T-clock is concerned, try to run it down the cable alongside a very close ground. Also check for any unterminated asynchronous reset pins, because you should keep TDO away from them as well to avoid getting spurious resets. And we'll come back to protecting reset lines a little later. If you're driving your board from an XJ-Link 2, you may have noticed there's an option to set many of the connector pins to what we've called soft grounds. These are not an absolute solid ground, there are only two of those, but they have sufficiently low impedance that they're going to do a good job of minimising crosstalk on a ribbon cable if you interleave them with all the signals. And if you're using individual wires rather than a ribbon cable, it's good to run TDO, TDI, T-clock, and TMS as four twisted pairs. Twist each signal with its own ground. And again here, use these soft grounds for TDO, TDI, and TMS. Here's an example of a good pinout for a ribbon cable if you're using two ports and so need to split the cable to go to two different places. Look at how each half has its own solid ground, and we've positioned T-clock so that the hard ground runs beside it, and those soft grounds will nicely interleave the other signals on the ribbon cable. By the way, if you've got any pins spare, then use them to run another ground wire up the cable. So, once we've done all that, we'll have a good foundation for our system. The next thing we need to look at is how to terminate those lines on the board being tested. Don't forget that JTAG is a high-speed interface, so its lines are going to need proper terminations, or the signal integrity is going to be bad. Taking T-clock first, this needs an RC series termination to match the characteristic impedance of the cable and PCB tracks. Put it as close as you can to the pin of the last device of each chain. Values of around 68 ohms and 100 picofarads should be about right. For TDO, we're going to need a small source termination. 22 ohms is a good rule of thumb, and obviously, put it near the TDO pin of the last device in each chain. The other thing to bear in mind is that the cable will probably pick up some noise, and you don't want that getting on any asynchronous inputs like a reset. So, if you've got a reset line in your cable, add a small RC filter. 10 ohms and 10 nanofarads should do just fine. Then we'll have to think about pull-ups and pull-downs. Test reset line. Pull that down to prevent anything accidentally going into test mode when the XJ-Link 2 isn't driving the signal. We recommend a 10K pull-down, but anything between 1 and 10 should be okay. TMS. We need a pull-up on that in case the clock lines has any glitches. You see, if there are any spurious clocks, having TMS high will ensure the tap state machine stays in its reset condition and so can't execute unintended instructions. TDI also wants a pull-up. This is going to help protect your system from any glitches on the clock, because if there are any spurious clocks, and we're holding this pin high, all that will happen is that we clock in ones, which just puts it into bypass mode, so a safe condition. Then think about TDO. Although it's thought of as an output, the spec says it should go into a tri-state condition when it's not scanning data. So if we don't have a pull-up, the input that it's feeding is free to just float around, which can cause problems. In fact, if you've got several devices in a chain, it's worth adding a pull-up on each TDO to TDI line. This will prevent the inputs on the board floating at those times. Now we have a system that's ready to go, but don't just plug it in and use it. Instead, invest a few minutes to run some checks first. And how to do that is the subject of our next video. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe for more and leave a like or comment below.